Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the first experiment of your CG Wheeler, that is implementation of Presenham's line drawing algorithm. Now this algorithm is basically used for drawing lines on your raster scan displays, and we need to input two endpoints of a particular line, and it uses a slope intercept formula to find out the intermediate points to draw a particular line. Now first of all, we are going to declare the variables for storing the two endpoints of a particular line. Those are x1, y1, x2, y2. These are the variables which are used to store the two endpoints of a particular line. Then we are going to initialize the glut environment by using my init function, where we have set the clear color, means we have set the background color as 000, means it is a black color. And we have created a window of size 0 to 500, means it is going to create a size window of 500 by 500. Then we have a function called draw pixel, which is used to draw a pixel onto the screen. Again, it takes two parameters, x axis point and y axis point, and it is going to draw a particular vertex onto the screen. Now the next comes the important function of this program, that is wide draw line. Now this function is going to draw the line using a Presenham's algorithm. Now the first step of this algorithm is to input the two endpoints of a particular line. Now to store those endpoints, we have these four variables: x1, x2, y1, y2. Now these are the two endpoints, and these are the temporary variables which are required: delta x, delta y, increment x, increment y, increment 1, increment 2. Now delta x and delta y are the, delta x is given by x2 minus x1, and delta y is given by y2 minus y1. Now if the delta x is less than 0, it indicates that delta x has to be given in negative value, hence we are going to use delta x is equals to minus delta x. And if similarly, if the delta y is less than 0, then delta y will be minus delta y. Then increment x will be 1, means we are going to increment x by 1. Now if x2 is less than x1, in that case we are going to have a value for delta y as negative, hence increment x will be minus. Similarly, for if y2 is less than y1, in that case increment y will be minus 1. Now first of all, we'll check the slope. Now for finding out the slope, we are going to use this formula: delta x is greater than delta y. If the delta x is greater than delta y, means the slope is less than 1. In that case, you draw that particular pixel onto the screen, that is draw pixel x comma y, means the first point you are going to draw. Then we are going to find out the decision parameter, that is e. Now e is equals to 2 into delta y minus delta x. Now for this decision parameter, based on this decision parameter, we are going to find out the next point to be used. Now based on this decision parameter, if this e's value is greater than or equal to 0, in that case we are just going to increment y, and we are going to increment this e also. E is equals to e plus increment 1. If the e value is not greater than or equal to 0, means it is less than 0, in that case we are going to assign e is equals to e plus increment 2. Now this increment 1 and increment 2, you are given here the formulas: increment 1 is equals to 2 into delta y minus delta x, and increment 2 is equals to 2 delta y. Now by using these two, we are going to find out the increments. Then x, we are going to increment x, x is equals to x plus increment x, that is nothing but either plus 1 or minus 1. Then finally you draw that particular pixel onto the screen by using a draw pixel. Now these steps are going to be repeated delta x times. Okay, this procedure is going to be repeated delta x times, and finally the complete line is going to be drawn by that particular draw line function. And in display function, we are just going to call this single function, that is draw line, with these four parameters. Now in main, first of all, we need to read the two endpoints of a particular line, x1, y1, x2, y2. Now after that, after reading that, you initialize the glut environment by calling glut init function. Then you create a window of size 500 by 500 and the glut init window position is going to be 0. Then you create that particular window and its title is Presenham's line drawing algorithm. Then you just call my display function, that is nothing but your display function, then glut main loop to display the window onto the screen. This is how we can implement the Presenham's line drawing algorithm. Now what we'll do, we'll save this file with .cpp extension and we'll run and we'll see how the line is going to be drawn. After saving the file, you open the terminal and give the following command, that is gcc expt1.cpp minus gl minus lglut minus glu. Now gcc is a compiler name, expt1.cpp is a file name, then minus gl minus lglut minus glu, these are the libraries which are going to be loaded to compile this particular file. After that, to run this particular file, give /a.out, then it will ask you to enter the two endpoints of a particular line, x1 y1 x2 y2. Just you enter the values for these. X1 I have entered 20, y1 20, x2 200, y2 200, and when I press enter, you can see a line which is drawn from 20 position to 200 position in a 500 by 500 window. The window size is 500 by 500 and the line is started at 20 and it is ended at 200. Now you can also see the intermediate points which are used in this while drawing this particular line. These are the intermediate points which are selected for drawing this particular point. This is how the particular line is going to be drawn using this Presenham's line drawing algorithm. Thank you.